Hi, I'm Angela from URender, and this video is the sum up of the beginner tutorial series. This is a walkthrough of how you can render this cute dragon from start to finish. Check out the previous videos for a more detailed walkthrough. We will go through the lighting, materials effects and post-processing and how you can render out the final image. If you like to set up this scene from start to finish, check out the other videos. Let me show you where you can download the trial. Request a URender trial license. Download URender for Cinema 4D. Run the installer. If you need help installing URender, check out our trial installation video guide to take a look at the installation manual. Then open the folder according to your Cinema 4D version. Now copy the URender folder, go to your preference folder, plugins folder, and paste. Restart Cinema and open URender Studio. Click on Manage License and copy the key that you received by email and click on Activate. You can download the scene and all the other in-between steps, just head to our website, downloads, examples and assets and scroll down. In the zip you can also find the final dragon scene, which I'm using right now. So we will start and do basic lighting with spotlights. Make sure to use our URender layout. First thing you are going to do is start URender and choose a different HDRI image. In this case, do the colored bubbles from the presets. You can find it in the texture folder as well. Decrease the exposure and turn off the IRL to see all the effects of the lights I will create. For this scene, I will use a warm tone for the key light and a cool color for the backlight. First, we are gonna create the first spotlight, put it in a null, Alt plus G, and rename it to key light. I will position this light so it comes from the front left side. So click on your key light, go to coordinates, and set the z-axis to -1000 cm. Next, change the rotation of the key light null group so that the light comes from the left side. Now go to the URender light tag, increase the intensity and change the color to a light yellow warm tone. And set the attenuation to inverse square. Now I change the radius decay, inner outer angle. Next go to the shadow and increase the sample radius and put the shadow map size to 4K. And set the sample radius to 1. Moving on to the second spotlight, I will turn off the first light we created. Same as the other one, put it in a null, rename it and position the backlight. And change the rotation of the group so that the light comes slightly from the right side to the front. Change the intensity, color, increase the sample radius. Put the shadow map size to 4K and set the sample radius to 1. Set the attenuation to inverse square and change the radius decay and inner outer angle. Now you can turn on both lights, key light and backlight. Go to your render settings to environment and increase the exposure. Increase the background blur slightly and turn on the image based lighting. That's it for the lighting. Moving on to materials, we created the texture of the dragon in Substance Designer. Let's start by creating a URender material first by double clicking here in the Material Manager. Rename it and assign it to the Moon Rock. Go to color, texture and upload the diffuse texture. After that, change the mix mode to multiply and set the color to a brown. Next to the normal map, go to texture and upload your normal map. For the reflectance, choose the roughness workflow and upload the glossiness texture. I'm also gonna enable the screen space reflections. Activate clear code and decrease the glossiness a little bit. Last step for the rocky subsurface. Start with the translucency first. Bring down all three values, strength, warp, lighting and shadow bias. Next, smooth everything out, decrease the strength, depth falloff to 1, sample distribution to 3 and the sample count to 100. Change the color to a light blue. Go Go on and create the second material. Rename it to body and assign it to the body. Same here, upload the diffuse texture and change the mix mode to multiply. Change the color. Upload the normal map and glossiness texture. Make sure to change the roughness workflow and enable SSR. Activate the clear coat channel and bring the glossiness down to 55%. Now enable subsurface, adjust the translucency and smooth everything out with the surface scattering. This time we're going to change the color to a light brown. Create the head material and assign it to the head. Upload the diffuse texture, change the mix mode to multiply and change the color. Upload the normal map and roughness texture. Change the roughness workflow and enable SSR. Bring down the clear coat glossiness. Go to subsurface, enable translucency, decrease the strength and increase the shadow bias. Smooth everything out with surface scattering and change the color to a light green. Next, create the wings material and assign it to the wings. Upload the diffuse texture, change to multiply and change the color. Upload the normal map and roughness texture. Turn the clear coat on and adjust the subsurface scattering. Double click to create the material for the eyes. Now click on the dragon wings low quality model and change to polygon mode. Make sure that you are in live selection mode. Now select both eyes by double clicking and assign the eye texture you just created. For the eyes, you simply just change the color to black, turn on the clear coat and adjust the glossiness. For the normal map, we're gonna reuse the wings normal map so that the eyes have some egg surface texture as well. Create the last material for the horns and teeth, rename it and assign it. Make sure to use polygon mode while selecting the faces for a double clicking. Upload the diffuse texture, change the mix mode to multiply and change the color. Now go to reflectance and upload the glossiness texture. Enable subsurface and adjust the translucency and surface scattering. That's it for the materials of the dragon. Now to the effects. For our dragon scene, we're gonna use the ground truth AO. We will just increase the sample steps to max, the power to 3. I will leave the bloom on and decrease the intensity to 0.5. For tone mapping, I'm just gonna use exponential this time. We're gonna increase the exposure to 2. I will turn down the chromatic aberration. For this scene, I will use vignette, but only bring down the strength to 30%. Now the color correcting. Select both points of the curve, right click and make the S-curve. So now we're going to position the camera. Just click on this icon to create a camera and you will create the viewport camera. I will position the camera roughly here in the viewport directly. Then I go to the camera settings to object and change the focal length to portrait. Now I'm gonna adjust the position of the camera. I will show you the actual candidates right now. Finished with the positioning of the camera, we will now move on to the render settings for final rendering. I'm just going to copy our existing low render settings and change the name to high quality. Go to Basic, Anti-Aliasing mode and enable multi-frame sampling. I will bring up the sample to around 8, but remember not to overdo it since more samples can slow down the performance significantly. Now the last step, go to Output, set the width and height and change the frame range to current frame to render out the single frame. Now just hit on render to picture view and save it to your preferred format. This is the last video of the beginner tutorial series. Hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching. As I already mentioned, check out the previous videos for a more detailed walkthrough. URender is the true real-time rendering software that permits you to achieve immediate noise-free rendering results in full resolution.